Welcome to Chapter 3 on this Masterclass discussion on liquidity management for banks. My name is Michael Imeson. I'm from the Banker magazine. I'm joined here by Christian Goerlach, who works for Global Transaction Banking at Deutsche Bank. And we've been talking about liquidity management and the impact that regulations have on this. In particular, in the last chapter, we were talking about collateral management and the intraday liquidity management. We're now going to talk about the liquidity manager's relationship with the central bank. So, Christian, with all these new regulations that are going to require much more collateral to be posted with the bank, and there's going to be a shortage of that collateral, is that going to mean that banks are going to have to deposit a lot of cash with the central bank? And if so, what sort of implications will that have?
Right. So you're absolutely right. You could access the intraday that we discussed, the intraday capacity, by either providing collateral or by leaving cash on the central bank. Collateral we discussed, there's a lot of demand coming for the same sort of collateral from different angles. So not only from the central bank for the clearing purposes, but also from the Basel regulation and also from margining from derivatives going forward. So cash is always an option. For cash, we already mentioned the leverage ratio earlier. So that is really taking up a resource. If you leave the cash at the central bank, have a low risk basically, and also a low return, especially in the current interest rate environment. But it's using up a resource, which is the balance sheet.
And does that cause internal divisions in the bank? Because you've got the liquidity risk managers on the one side saying they need all this cash, but on the other side, you've got the business managers who are saying that that's trapped liquidity that could be put to better use elsewhere.
Yeah, I mean, from a profitability point of view, you're absolutely right. You would not want to have too much liquidity lying around idle at the central bank. On the other side, you need to make sure that you're able to do it. It's not black and white. You could say that there's also middle ground. If you have too much cash, then you lose out on the profitability. Then there's an area where I would say that from a liquidity risk perspective, it's still okay, but then you're basically eating into your service quality for yourself, but also if you provide clearing services to clients, for your clients, because they expect you to settle at certain times within the day or to have a minimum standard. So I think this is the area where it gets tricky, because when you come to the liquidity risk, I'm sure that all the banks have learned their lessons over the last years and there's no compromise on the liquidity risk side. But there is this area between where you're okay from a liquidity risk perspective, but service quality is a topic, and banks need to make a choice or a decision on how much service quality they want and how much they want to spend for that.
And where would you say the balance is falling at the moment? Is the balance still towards in favour of the liquidity risk manager rather than the people wanting to make extra return on that trapped liquidity?
That is a good question. I would say, especially when I look in Europe, but to a degree also in the US, because we had so much liquidity in the market, because the central bank basically flushed the markets, everybody appears to be okay. So we are really on this side where everybody has a lot of liquidity. But now we are seeing central bank balance sheet going back, so less liquidity in the market. And I think there's a saying, when the tide goes away, you see who is swimming naked. And I think that is something that we will see in the next months and quarters.